There they are! Don't let them get any farther! Don't let them get into that room! We have to stop them! Huh, sounds like something's in that room. I'll take care of this. You two keep on moving. What? But... Don't underestimate me. These two are nothing. I can handle them. Let's do it! I'll take you all on! Roy has earned our title of BAMF of the day. Or just badass. Yeah, there we go. He's a badass. Overall! Sergey. Ah. We had an intruder report, but I never suspected it would be you. Marcia, what are you doing here? Oh boy. Rahu. So you know about Rahu. What are you planning on doing with Rahu? It has nothing to do with you. But since you came all the way here, I'll tell you. Our Z researchers are remodeling Rahu. We're making a model people can dive into. Once we control Rahu's destructive powers, we'll be invincible. The government, the police squad, everyone in the world will be under our command. The world is mine!
But Rahu is a horrific entity. It destroyed our world and nearly wiped out the human race.
You know a lot. That's why we're remodeling it, so I can control its horrific powers. I was wondering why you showed up here in this outside world. I didn't know you knew about Rahu. So you're Class S now, aren't you?
Yes. Sergey, why are you doing this? There must be something that's on your mind. At least tell me your reason. Why, Sergey?
I hate to interrupt, but... Sorry, Sergey. Even though she's your younger sister, she's seen our hideout. We can't let her leave. I understand. You can't!
Sergey...
Poor girl. Looks like Sergey understands that a well-ordered world is more important than his own little sister. I can't believe you do this. That's awful! You don't know how much Marcia's worried about you. She placed her trust in you when no one else would! She's always thinking of you!
Thank you, Dark. It's over. My memories of my brother can never be replaced, but... those memories have nothing to do with this battle now. Dark, that's why we can't hold back against him.
But Marcia, he's your only brother!
If I had to choose, I'd rather fight my brother than betray my friends. Sergey, I still believe in you. Let's go, Dark. We won't lose!
Who else said? Don't overdo it, though. Forgive me, Sergey. Let's go! Oh, bro.
Sergey!
Sergey, you! Alright, a fight against Oboro. If that model looks familiar, it seems to be the same one from the beginning of the freaking games of the story intro. So, we have our partners here, which is A, Marcia, and then B, Sergey. But his parts are all illegal. Which I'm not too shocked about, actually. Being a member of Z, your parts would be almost technically illegal if you're an admin, which these two certainly are. We'll stick with that for now. Change the Gemini P to the Tomahawk B, and change our color back to red. Well, no, not red. Ugh, red's ugly. Back to the original. Feather we can change to... with wide jump. There we go. New parts for a new battle. Sure, let's do this thing. Oh, mystical red Robo Launcher, where I go, only you shall know. Ah, crud, you're putting me next to Oboro, you cruddy game, you. Hey, you don't get the teleport. No, Bill, I guess the teleport! Ever! Get back up, Dark! Or Ray, I don't care who you are, you get back up and you fight. This is a kind of a one-sided fight right here, because we have both ourselves, Marcia, and Sergei, both who are extremely talented Robo Commanders. And dare I say, I'm actually glad we have Sergei on our side, even though he was technically a villain. I'm guessing he saw the light of his little sister's heart. Which I would totally buy, honestly. Final shot was mine! It was mine, darn it! Mine! With that, hi-ya-ta! What is the meaning of this, Sergei? It's simple, Obolo. I've deceived you. All this time, I've been following the orders of another. You've betrayed me for Elise, haven't you? Oh, I know. You want Rahu for yourself. You're wrong, Obolo. I don't work for Elise, nor do I want to keep Rahu for myself. Rahu does not belong to anyone, nor should it be tampered with. Rahu is a dangerous entity. We must stop it before it evolves. My main objective was to bring someone here who could stop Rahu.
What kind of nonsense is that? I don't care what your goals are, Sergei. You've deceived me, and you're trying to interfere with my work. You scoundrel! How dare you deceive me? I won't forgive you for this. I won't! Rahu belongs to me. I won't let anyone take it.
Give it up, Obolo. There's nothing you can do to stop me, not in the state you're in.
Give up! Give up! A worthless scoundrel like you telling me to give up. Me, the great Obolo! I'll crush you! You think you can get away with this? I'll crush you all! Just you wait! I'll dive into Rahu and crush you all!
Fool! The redesign isn't complete! Do you know what the consequences are? We have to stop Rahu. Dark, help me please.
Marcia, don't! We have to retreat.
Not an option. Oh boy. Oh goody, it's back. Oh man, I hate Rahu so much. Okay. Our next battle is with Rahu. Again! This is, what, our third round with the guy? Oh! His arena changed. He's green, so I want to stay far away from him. Oh, I went closer to green! Ah! Wow, he got back up fast! Darn you! His arena totally changed. Look at this thing. It went from a park-like to some kind of... Well, it looks like a redesigned Oberos Colosseum, but it's greener and not as blight and desolate. Ah! Up, Ray. We have to destroy Rahu! At all costs, destroy Rahu! Nope! Nope! Get back here and you die! Hey! I said you die! Ouch! Did he kill himself there? Wow, I'm on top of the building! Hi-ya-ta! That's what you get for messing with steel hearts. That's what you get.
We did it!
That can't be! Rahu! It refused to listen to me! How could it reject me, the mighty Omuro? How did I lose?
Rahu cannot be controlled. Not by Omuro, not by anyone. When Omuro died, Rahu's strength was drained as it tried to reject Omuro from its systems. It was still too strong for Omuro. The idea of controlling Rahu is just impossible.
Rahu!
Rahu. Are you two okay?
Sergei. Roy. Long time no see.
Sergei.
How have you been, Captain Myra?
What's Obero doing on the floor? And my Sergei with you. What's going on here?
The Sergei fought alongside us. He defeated Obero.
What happened?
So, Marcio, where is Rahu now?
It escaped.
Escaped?
Obero tried to dive into Rahu, but it didn't seem like Rahu liked it, so it rejected him and flew off. Diving into Rahu? What?
Sergei, what's going on? I'll explain it in detail, Captain Myra. Well, let's go into a different room. Please, follow me.
Get.
I can use water for this next part.
Where are we?
This room belonged to our leader, who passed away not too long ago.
Z's leader?
Yes. Someone here needs to hear my leader's final words. This is why I brought you to this place.
Someone? Who? Who is it?
Please, listen. These are my leader's final words. Dark, you'll never know how proud I am to know how proud I am that you have come so far.
Hey, Dark, how come he knows your name?
That voice, it's my dad.
What?
It can't be. Is he Syndicate's leader? Is Dark's father?
I'm gonna continue playing the message. Dark, if you're listening to this message, that means Rahu has returned. And our time is short. I wish that I could have been here to see you, to fight with you, in this final, glorious moment. However, if you are hearing this, it also means my time has come. And I am long gone from this world. I have given you my loyal friend, Sergei, details on your mission. Trust him as you would have trusted me. I do not have much time left. Give Sergei the watch I gave you to care for so long ago. With the power contained in that watch, you can defeat Rahu. I have failed you as a father in life, and my final wish in death is nothing but a fool's errand. I am sorry, son. That was his final message. The watch. My dad told me to keep it on at all times, never to take it off. He said it over and over, and I promised him so many times. And he left me.
Dark.
Sergei, what's going on? Like you and Roy, I learned about the outside world when I became a Class S commander. Though you disappeared right after you found out about it. Sergei, why did you leave without telling us? Because I met my boss.
Boss? You mean Z's boss?
When I found out about the outside world, I became curious. I wanted to explore it. And there, I met my boss. I was surprised to discover someone living in the outside world.
And?
He asked me, why are you here? And I told him that I wanted to know the truth about the outside world. Then he asked, is there something you need to protect? And I said yes. Marcia, my sister, you were the one I wanted to protect.
Sergei.
We spoke for some time, discussing life in our dome and outside. Finally, he asked me, do you want to protect this world from annihilation?
Annihilation?
Yes. I have to admit it, I really didn't understand his question. But I could see in his eyes that he was very serious indeed. I stopped to think, and I said yes. He continued, as long as you remain in your world, you will never see the truth. The truth lies in darkness. If you discover an inconsistency in your perfectly ordered world, where all things are controlled, anything that cannot be explained, come see me again, and I may be able to help you. Tell no one that we met. Tell no one what we have discussed. With that, we parted ways. I thought about what he said, but I could not find any inconsistencies. That's because there are none. Roy, be quiet and listen. Continue, Sergei. Then suddenly, I found it. It was right in front of me from the start. When I returned home, I saw my sister waiting for me, and it struck me.
The inconsistency, that single, unexplainable thing. It was Marcia, her special power. Her strange power was a gift. My late parents, they were suffering.
Sergei.
To all appearances, Marcia is an ordinary girl. And yet, the kids teased her. The scientists poked and prodded, and they still learned nothing. Marcia didn't want to go, but the researchers forced her, kicking and screaming. So that's why Marcia hated the Robo researchers. I found out what they did to Marcia at the research center. It wasn't science, it was torture. They say that all people are created equal, but my sister's power stole her equality from her. If this isn't an inconsistency, then what is? How did I go so long without questioning this? I couldn't wait. Once I seen the inconsistency clearly, I had to leave, to meet him again. I told him about Marcia, and he said, in order to understand everything, you must know everything. And he told me the real truth, something even most Class S commanders do not know. The real truth. Well, what do you mean? You're all aware that centuries ago, Robin nearly wiped out the human race. Yeah, we were told that Rahu annihilated all the domed cities that people lived in except for ours. You were never told the truth outside of the world, about the outside world. You believe we lived in domes up here? Well, yeah, I mean, where else could we live? We lived free, in the outside world. We lived in vast cities, in the open air. Rahu destroyed all of that.
What? Really?
Originally, humans didn't live in domed cities. We lived outside. The outside world was our home. Rahu destroyed all of our cities centuries ago. The few who survived found an area that had minimal damage, and with the help of robot technology, they built a dome to create a livable environment for a new community.
I see.
We hadn't heard about that part. We thought people had always lived inside these domes. You are correct, but there is still more that you do not know. The dome builders left Rahu inoperable in the outside world before they sealed themselves in.
Sergei, it sounds like you're saying we deliberately chose to live in cages, like animals.
That's right. The domes protect us, but it also keeps us trapped, caged.
Wait a sec, you said Rahu was inoperative. So how did we stop Rahu last time?